Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and this is the new Apple CarPlay in iOS 13, and it doesn't look terribly different, but you may notice this new icon down here. But let's first take a look at some new apps. So we now have a calendar and settings. Let's go into settings first, and you'll see we have three options now. We now have Do Not Disturb While Driving, Appearance, and Suggestions in Dashboard. So if we go into Do Not Disturb, we can activate this with Apple CarPlay, or it's off by default. We also have Appearance, so we can have it be automatic based on day, night, or whether or not your lights are turned on. And also, always use dark mode. I'll just leave it in automatic for now. We also have Suggestions in Dashboard. This is on by default, and it's Siri suggestions based on things that are in your calendar. Now, if we go to Calendar, you'll see we have one thing here I've put in here. I don't really use Calendar too much, so you'll see it says Record Apple CarPlay Video. If I tap on this, we can get directions to where we need to go to record that, and I just put in a destination. So if we tap on this, we can hit go, and you'll see that interface for maps is a little bit different. And we have a couple options in here now as well. Now there is a new junction view, but we do have share ETA. So if you want to share your ETA with someone, you can just share it and it will send via SMS if they're on Android, something like that. And then also, there are some changes for manufacturers. They can now implement the Hey feature when you say Siri after that and allow it to use it throughout the OS. But during this particular navigation session, if we hit this button here, you'll see we can search for something else. We can share the ETA like I said before. And if we search for something else, we could add a gas station. So if we want to add a gas station, maybe we'll add this to our route and you'll see it pops right up there. Now everything seems to be pretty fast so far on this, so we'll add this one to it and it brings us there, or we can just end the route altogether. We also have our favorites, search, and destination. Then we can go to 3D. And based on where you're located, this map will be updated throughout the year. It could look better as well. We can zoom in or zoom out, depending on the actual head unit that you have in your car, whether it's factory or aftermarket like this one, it may be a little bit different based on what you have. Now on the home screen, we have a new view. If I hit this button, we've got our map here. We also have our suggestions for where we may navigate to. We have our currently playing song or last playing, and also our calendar. So this is a Siri suggestion view, and we can go right into calendar from here. And everything's actually pretty fast when you're navigating around. Now they've updated music as well, so if we go into music, it doesn't look too different here, but if we actually browse music, it looks a little different. So if we go to For You, we'll wait for it to load, and you'll see we have recently played, personalized mixes, and music now supports Bluetooth from your phone to show you the album art. So if you're streaming from your phone and it didn't show the album art before, it will now. And then we have radio, and now playing, which is animated. It's really nice. So I'll hit play. So the song is playing, I just have it muted. And then if I go back home, go into music, we'll go back, you'll see it's animated as though it's playing the song. We can go right back into it. It's very fast and fluid. Now a major change they've made is Siri. And Siri is quite good, but we'll tap and hold. Navigate to the closest gas station.
The closest one I found is Sitgoani Independence Boulevard.
Okay, go there.
Getting directions to Sitgo.
And you'll see it gets directions. It's pretty fast, no problems there. And it seems to work just fine. And now messages gets a little bit of a revamp as well. If we go into messages, then we'll go and text family member here.
One moment. What do you want to say?
I'm just testing out Siri using Apple CarPlay.
Your message to Chad Zollo says I'm just testing out Siri using Apple CarPlay. Ready to send it?
So you'll see it's a little bit different. I can send it, cancel, change it, and it looks a little different now. So overall, it's pretty nice. The final thing that's new is when you're using your phone and maybe I go into music, it no longer changes on this display. So if I go into music, I go home, or maybe I go into, say, Google Maps, it doesn't open up on the display here. It lets you use it independently of Apple CarPlay, which is really, really nice. So that's it for the new redesign. Of course, if they introduce any new changes, I'll share those when this comes out. But let me know what you think in the comments below. It's very simple, and car manufacturers can change how it looks on larger displays as well. Let me know what you think in the comments below. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe and like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.